Hey guys, so I wanted to share with you this idea I got actually about a year and a half ago. I painted a seascape, a wave, using a wax crayon, and I just didn't like my wave back then. It was the beginning of, like, I was still discovering different ways to paint the waves. But one of my ideas was, well, why would I use wax? So basically, in this video, you do not need to have watercolor white or white gouache, or you don't need to have masking fluid, and you don't need to do it the other hard way. Actually, the hard way would be preserving that white on the paper and going around and painting to make sure you have that seafoam created. So here what I'm doing is I am pressing hard with my wax, and this could be a candle basically. I'm pressing hard on the paper and I'm marking all the areas that I want that seafoam to be. So I'm creating a seafoam right now. It's like an invisible lines, but whatever I see white, this is where I'm going over with my crayon. I'm using a flat brush, 3/4 heritage brush by Princeton, and this is a softer brush, and I'm starting wet on dry. So the paper is dry, I didn't pre-wet it. I'm just adding colors, starting with leaf green, and after that I'm gonna mix a little bit of the leaf green with sap green. I guess first going for the sand colors, you can use yellow ochre with quin red, or burnt sienna. Here I am using Vandyke brown, whichever colors you can read on your reference photo, or if you're painting from imagination, just want to use sand colors, something that reminds you of sand the most. And then you want to blend the sand colors with a sea color. So because underwater the sand mixes with water, and you can see that, like, pretty clearly with those aerial views. So you want to have nice blending. You can start the whole thing wet on wet as well, which is probably easier for the colors to blend at the same time nicely and in a smooth way. When you do it like me, wet on dry, you do have to work the paper very fast because the paper is drying. Whenever you go with your strokes, that stroke will dry pretty quickly, so you kind of have to connect all these areas together pretty fast. You gotta go fast. I'm just adding colors, different colors for the sea, for the ocean, and at the same time working the sand. So my eyes are on the entire paper. I don't just focus in one area. I need to see my entire painting the whole time. It's like my eyes are going from left to right, left to right. And this is how I keep an eye on my paper, what area is drying and where I don't want. If I don't want hard edge, this is where I'm gonna go work on the area next, right away, before the paper is drying. For the sand, like, you can, there's white sand, you have some red sand, pink sand, you have this brownish sand. It depends what kind of sand you want to paint. These are more like richer colors, and I like to add quin red a lot to my sand paintings. And then closer to the sea foam, you also want darker tone a little bit, especially when you see that sea from the top, you'll be able to see the shadows and stuff like that. I just kept working a lot with that one brush, but then there's other brushes you can use. You can use round brushes, you can use even the regular brush. A lot of times when I paint seascape, I do use a regular brush. And I'm just adding more colors for more vibrancy. So it's important to keep adding these colors as your paper is still wet. If it starts to dry, it's okay. You just have to go in that area right away. Like right now, that part started to dry. So I'm just adding more color, and because I'm not done working there yet, I need everything to blend nicely. And obviously I added in the middle section some of the browns, but that's because that sand is mixing with water. I need to show that in my painting. And then again, the paper's drying, so I'm adding more paint to the left. You can just add water if you don't want your painting to be that vibrant at the same time. So on top of my lighter blues on the left side, I start adding darker tones, darker blues. And then just spots, like when you look at the water from the top, you do see, like, there's spots, like there's the depth in the ocean. Like you can see some areas are deeper, some areas are more shallow. So now this is the long round eight brush by Princeton Aqua Elite series. I'm just dipping my brush in water, wiping in a towel, and I was going over the areas because that opens up some of that those spots. Basically, I was lifting up, and here I'm adding shadows that are shadows and also colors of ocean, more closer to the sea foam. So I'm using the tip of my brush to do that. So this brush is actually pretty versatile because you can use it, the tip of the brush, for smaller details, and then if you want more paint and larger strokes, you just do it like this, like with more paint. I'm adding a little bit of blues at the same time there, because that we can see that watercolors, the colors of water, also on the sea foam. And then to darken up the side, the sand from the top, you can see that there's that shadow underneath the wave and underneath that sea foam. So you want to add these colors a little, you want to create the contrast. That's what I'm trying to say. You want to create contrast, and it's best to mix different colors. Thank you so much, guys, and I hope you really enjoyed this. This is like one of my newer ideas, and I really wanted to share it with you because this is the best way if you do not have masking fluid or you do not have white gouache. Thank you so much for watching.